And property obviously is a big part of this. I mean, it's obviously been a big reason why we've seen the economy slow down. Are we starting to see a floor, though, on property? Is the property decline coming to an end?
It will take time, and we estimate that the inventory level, or we usually use the inventory turnover ratio, the existing inventory as a ratio to the property sales, is still 3.5 years. So it takes 3.5 years for China to digest all the existing inventory. That's not the biggest issue. The biggest issue is the policy stand of the top government. So far, they pledge to or they want to stop the property price to fall further, but it doesn't mean that they have changed the policy, and the overall policy stand is still to support affordable housing and leaving the private market for upgrading. But the majority of the of the housing demand will still be fulfilled by the affordable housing, which is a public housing project. So the old days used to be the regime that favoring the private sector, but this regime doesn't seem to be, or seems to me that this regime has ended, and the verbal intervention by the Kulubra has not solved this problem.
Well, and it's easy moving into this new economy, right? I mean, we're kind of moving from property development towards digitisation, in particular, you know, AI, EV. This is all going to be a focus of China's economy going forward. Is this bringing long, or will this bring long-term growth?
That's the hope of the Chinese authorities. Of course, that all countries want to boost their total factor productivity by going digital, by even by going green and by going tech and innovation. I think this is a very legitimate policy direction, and it's very reasonable. But the problem is how big these industrial policy can help the current economic problem facing the economy. If China is has already entered a lost decade with a severe deflationary scenario, facing the economy, and households are not believing in property, and the asset price continue to shrink, and we name for this a balance sheet recession. If this happened, I'm not quite sure, you know, how the industrial policy and the long-term economic reform can fix this asset price deflation scenario, which will be the main issue facing the economy over the next 2 or 3 years.
Yeah, of course, the US election coming up as well. There does seem to be bipartisan support for restrictive trade policies with China. So how does this impact the economy going forward?
A optimistic scenario is just 10% increase in tariff. A worst scenario would be 60% or even higher tariff rate imposed on Chinese goods. Now, the immediate impact based on what happened a few years back when Donald Trump was the president, we had seen an increase in export before the tariff imposed on China. But the longer term impact obviously is the drop of Chinese goods exporting to the U.S. directly. There has been a lot of supply chain realignment, and production facility has been moved to other countries, Vietnam, Mexico, and Indonesia. This will be an ongoing process. So whoever becomes the U.S. president, I don't see that will change the or reverse the direction. Between the in the bilateral economic relationship between China and the U.S. So I would just think that over the next 2 or 3 years that the direct export between China and the U.S. Will continue to be shrinking.
Yeah, certainly worse off if Trump gets in. Raymond, really appreciate your time on the program today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Ingrid.